So I think that most people consider a vitamin deficiency coming from a lack of eating certain things in your diet, right? And you may know that consuming pure sugar or refined sugar will cause a vitamin deficiency. And of course, all the refined grains and caffeine. And if you have a lack of bile, let's say you don't have a gallbladder or you have a problem with your liver, you can't make bile, you're going to be deficient in vitamin A, D, E, and K. Those are fat-soluble vitamins. And then if you don't have enough microbiome, your friendly bacteria, you'll also have vitamin deficiencies. And if you don't have enough stomach acid, you're not going to be able to absorb the minerals into your body because you need a very strong acid stomach to absorb minerals. And then there's the anti-nutrients, like phytates, which block zinc, and tannins, which block the B vitamins. And then you have oxalates, like and spinach, and rhubarb, and almonds, which will block calcium. The calcium instead gets stuck in your kidney. So there's a lot of data on these things, but did you realize that stress will also cause vitamin deficiencies, not to mention all sorts of other health problems, and especially a lowered immune system? So let's talk about that. So right here we have the SIBO Collection of Medical Illustrations, Volume 4, Endocrine System. And I'm going to flip to the page about cortisol. So when we're talking about stress in the body, we're really talking about the hormone cortisol. Cortisol goes up and it creates a whole series of effects. So in this page, it talks about several nutrients becoming lost when you have high levels of chronic output of cortisol. But vitamin B1 deficiency usually comes from consuming too much refined sugar, but it also comes from having high levels of stress over a period of time. And this is probably one of the reasons when you take B1, you just feel like such a relief of stress. So if you want a nice calm sensation, nutritional yeast, or take a natural B1, not the synthetic version, and you're gonna feel very stress-free. Also, vitamin D. Stress causes the receptor for vitamin D to be downgraded. So that means you're not going to be able to absorb vitamin D efficiently. And when we're talking about vitamin D deficiencies, a couple symptoms are anxiety, depression, lack of good restorative sleep. So vitamin D is very, very important. And then we have a zinc deficiency. And zinc has a lot to do with neurotransmitters and stabilizing your mood. And then we have a potassium deficiency, which is right on this page. People will tend to lose potassium when they go through stress. And initially, they retain sodium, so they have fluid retention. So we have low potassium and high sodium. So that could potentially increase your blood pressure, cause fluid retention. But potassium is very important in stabilizing your pulse rate. For example, if your potassium is low, your pulse rate will go up. Your blood pressure will go up. Your arteries will become stiffened. So potassium is like a physiological tranquilizer. It's calming. It's really good for sleep. And this is why I recommend a lot of potassium, because our bodies really need 4,700. Very few people get this much. But it's very interesting when a person starts to get this amount from increasing their vegetables or taking it as an electrolyte, they start having more energy and they start sleeping better and they just feel a lot more calm. And then as stress goes on and the adrenals start becoming burnt out, then you start to lose sodium. So when your stress is really high, this could be one of the reasons why people crave a lot of salty foods when they're stressed. All right, so if you haven't seen my video on the stress webinar, you should probably check that out. I put it right here.